Get your backpack ready. Let's brainstorm another trip. This week in our whirlwind tour of the history of science, let's travel to the 16th century, the 1500s. I hope you'll make some meaningful and unexpected discoveries this week as we explore the strange new world of the century of the Reformation, the era of Copernicus, Tycho Brahe, and Kepler. Though we have a limited time to visit, we'll not be like tourists in Uraniborg or Prague who seek fast food at McDonald's. Our aim will be to get to know the 16th century astronomers in terms of their own place and time, not just in terms of modern science. As always, when we're planning a trip, we want to better understand what people in this place and time were up to. What are some similarities between 16th century culture and our culture today? How might these similarities help us to understand 16th century science? What are some differences between 16th century culture and our culture today? And how might these differences pose an obstacle to our understanding of 16th century science? What do you think is the chief barrier or prejudice that obstructs modern appreciation of science in the Reformation era? What do you know about astronomy in the 16th century? Have you heard of Copernicus, Tycho, or Kepler? What would you most like to discover about them this coming week? Please share your thoughts on these things and feel free to revisit any of the questions from last week. What are your starting assumptions?